Good morning everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. So today we are going to start with our next lecture, that is lecture number 4, and in this lecture I am going to teach you about the tenses, which we have already started in the previous lecture only. I am going to further classify the tense. So in the previous lecture I taught you about the simple present tense and what was the rule of that tense: subject plus verb first form, s or es and object. So today we are going to start with the next type, that is present continuous. That is present continuous. You all can see this table, as present tense contain 4 types. It has contains, see, it is simple present, present continuous, present perfect, and the last one is present perfect continuous. So today we are going to start with the second one, that is present continuous. It's very simple. See, continuous means verb first form plus ing. Continuous means jo kaam chal raha hai, jo kare ho raha hai, jo kare ho raha hai. The recognition of this tense is at the end of the sentence you are going to find raha hai, rahi hai, rahe hai. Now what are the uses of this present continuous tense? To express the action in progress or the continuity of the action at the time of speaking. Means the action is going on right now and we are speaking side by side. At that time of speaking only, the action is going on. Like the boys are swimming into the pool. He is teaching in the school nowadays. The birds are flying in the sky. While speaking, the actions are going on. They are in continuity. Fine. The next use is. To describe the action in progress but not necessarily at the time of speaking. The action happens, the action takes place, but it is not at the time of speaking now. The action goes on, but it is not at the time of speaking. Like examples are, what are you writing these days? These days you are writing something, but you are not doing it at the time of speaking. I am writing a book on grammar. Means the person is in continuation of writing the book on grammar, but it is not at the time of speaking. To express an action definitely planned for near future. The action which we have planned for near future. The action that will happen in future, but we are talking about it in present. Fine. We are talking about that same action in present, but it will take place in future, near future. Like the example is, the school is closing next Saturday. Next Saturday, the school will definitely close. But right now, we are talking about it. My uncle is arriving here tomorrow. The uncle will arrive here tomorrow. Action will take place tomorrow. But right now, we are talking about that particular action. It means the action which we have planned for tomorrow, it's for near future. But we are talking about it right now. So those all were the uses of the present continuous tense. Now next is the formation, how we frame sentences in different kinds, like in affirmative, in negative, in interrogative. So we are going to start with its formation. So let us start with the first formation, that is affirmative sentences. Affirmative sentences, they are just simple sentences. They starts with a capital letter and they ends with a full stop. Simple sentences. So what is the rule over here? What is the formation for present continuous tense? That is subject, the basically the doer in the sentence, then is, am, are, helping verb. I have already told you the use of these helping verbs, like is used with third person singular, am with I, and are is used with third person plural, second person and first person plural, and then first form of the verb, then ing plus object. Like examples are, the girls are sitting in a group, he is asking a question. The hens are laying eggs. The babies are crying loudly. The boys are playing in the field. The frogs are hopping on the land. You all can see over here, there is a subject in the beginning of the sentence. Then we have the helping verb, then the verb first form, then ing, then the object. I hope you all would have understood this. These are affirmative simple sentences. Now let us move on to the negative sentences. In negative sentences, as you all know, we deny to do some action. We say no to something. Fine. There is no change. Just there is an addition of the word not. Look over here in the rule. that is subject SMR plus not plus verb first form plus ing plus object. Whenever we talk about any continuous tense, there over there we need to add verb first form plus ing. That will be the same in all, be it present continuous, be it past continuous, be it future continuous, it will be the same. Now see the examples. I am going away for a while. I is the subject, am is the helping verb, not for negative, go verb first form, go is the verb first form, then we are adding ing to it. Fine. He is not sleeping right now. I am not feeling like something is wrong. The teacher is not reading a story about kingdoms. We are not going home. You are not playing football. So all these are the example of negative sentences. After that we have interrogative. In interrogative sentences we frame questions. In these sentences the helping verbs comes in the beginning of the sentence. We start, the helping verb comes in the beginning of the sentence, like see this, there is a formation of it also. SMR plus subject, then verb first form plus ing, then object, and it is compulsory to use a question mark while framing an interrogative sentence. Now look at the examples over here, like is she singing a song. Now is the helping verb over here, it is in the beginning. Is the helping verb, she is the subject, sing plus verb first form, sing is the verb first form, then ing, a song, then there is a question mark. Kya vah gana ga rahi hai, fine. Are the boys playing in the field? Are the frogs hopping on the land? Am I working hard? Is the school closing next Sunday? Am I doing well? So all these are interrogative sentences. Now let's see, that's a brief summary of this present continuous tense, and it is also known as present progressive tense. See, these are again the uses, action that are happening now. We talk about the action which are going on right now. She is cooking in the kitchen. Actions that are temporary. See, the example is they are staying in the London for few days. That is not the permanent stay, but they are staying temporarily over there. Then definite future plans. I already told you when we talk about the near future plans. I am going hiking tomorrow. What do you mean by hiking over here? Hiking. Hiking means going for a long walk. I am going for hiking tomorrow. So this is your homework. I hope you all have understood the present continuous tense and you will be able to do. These are the 7 sentences and these are next till 15. Fine. Whatever you are not able to understood, or your parent, you can write in the comments below. Fine. Then you will get the reply as soon as possible. Now this is the homework solution of lecture number 3. Fill in the blanks with present indefinite. Present indefinite means present simple, simple present, verb subject, verb first form, s or es plus object. Now let us start. You can see the first sentence over here. My friend dash me, verb is help. So we are going to write my friend helps me. I dash late on Saturday, I sleep late on Saturday. He dash to beach every weekend, he goes to beach every weekend. He is the singular subject, so we are going to use plural verb. They dash to college daily, they go to college daily. Kids do not dash the medicines, kids do not like the medicines. Why we are not using likes over here? Because kids is plural over here, so with plural we use singular verb. Do you dash some help? Do you need some help? Does he dash to take admission in college? Does he want to take admission in college? Does David dash game properly? Does David play game properly? Now next 9th one is, do you dash to like, do you like to play chess? She knows how to speak Spanish. I move towards my home after walking. He wants to participate in extracurricular activities. The patient takes medicine on time. I take exercise regularly. She loves her children too much. That's it. So I hope you all have understood the present continuous also. Do practice the simple present and present continuous. Complete the exercise. Okay, thank you.